Usually the TV or PC screen will suffice to watch our videos, but not today. This one merits a cinema screen. We're in Monte Carlo, the place everyone wants to live. Not me, though. I want to live on a mega yacht and just tour the world. Welcome to Atlante, a 55-meter boat designed and built by the Italian boatyard CRN in Ancona. The exterior design is by Nuvolari and Leonard, the Italian design studio, and interiors are by Giles and Boissier, who are a couple of French architects that have decked out some very wonderful residences across the world. So prepare yourselves for something quite extraordinary. When one thinks of a yacht, one thinks luxury. But here at the Boat Show, of course, we think sailing. So we really like the idea that it was a boatyard that produced merchant ships that built this. After all, its substance that, no, by that I mean how solid the structure is, how powerful the boat is, how safe and calm you are while sailing. But as well as the naval engineering, we've got an awful lot more. Looking around, I can see all sorts of mega yachts that are all quite similar. CRN, though, in the past few years has produced some quite diverse models with various architects and designers. It's been to their advantage too, as it isn't a fleet they are offering, but the mega dream of the mega ship owner.
Guardate questo ponte di prua, è fantastico, pulitissimo.
Look how this bridge at the bow is fantastic, really clean. There isn't even a bollard or anchor winch. So how does it moor up?
Venite a vedere.
Come and see.
È tutto
It's all underneath here.
Di solito sui mega yacht questa zona non viene sfruttata per yacht.
Usually this area on a mega yacht isn't used for guests, but here they've even put in a foldaway table, which varies the thickness because it fits into this recess of the bridge. Everything, every object on this boat is a design masterpiece. Look at this carbon pole that holds up the sunshade. It has a spotlight in it. Every captain wants to have a command post that is ultimate high-tech. It's all touch here, even the doors. This scale bar meter tells you the power input going into the machines. So much technology, but everything that happens always has to be recorded in the logbook too. In the machine room, there are three energy generators. Two are permanently working, and there's one reserve. So altogether, they generate 436 kilowatts, the equivalent electricity needed to run 70 houses. What I like about this project is the idea that an entire bridge has been dedicated to the boat owner, who can decide whether they want to have it for themselves or share it with guests, welcoming them into this living room.
The
smaller entertaining area offers up various potential solutions for relaxing. Armchairs, angled and well-lit sofas. But if you were in a bay instead of moored up in a port like we are now, who knows if we'd be able to see out of these windows. You know how much marble they've used on this 55-meter yacht? 20 tons,
l'equivalente del peso di uno
which is the same weight as a 17-meter yacht.
Quella dell'armatore non è semplicemente una.
And this isn't just a main cabin, it's really an apartment. The luxury is highlighted with just how big it is. Have you seen the sofa? Well, yes, it's not just a sofa, it's a limousine.
Qui tutto è possibile.
Here, anything is possible. If you want tea, it's here. The Atlante series is seriously impressive. It has a very strong personality that stands it apart and makes it easily recognizable. Do you know what it's made of? The hull is steel, so it's seriously strong. The superstructure is aluminium, so it's incredibly light. And if you put lots of weight down low and little above, you know you're getting the best stability. I really like it because its bigger parts, like the deckhouse, have the same geometrical design as the smaller ones. Now that's design. The handrails have a trapezoidal section, studded so they reflect the light, like the steel in the superstructure. The architects have designed the tall windows so they open up onto the sea, with the help of some low gunwales too.
Persino l'asta della bandiera è un'opera d'arte, meriterebbe di essere esposta al MoMA. Avete visto quanto è grande?
Have you seen how big it is? It's 55 meters long, and all morning going back and forwards. Well, that's a few kilometers. I need a coffee break.
Quando si mettono insieme le capacità degli ingegneri e la
And when you add in all the engineering expertise and the Italian creativity, you come out with something wonderful that others can't even imagine. Like this majestic stern that gives you two ways onto the boat. One is a traditional ladder, the other crosses the beach club. It's an oasis of relaxation. There's a solarium, lounge area, bar, and inside a Turkish bath, gym, and massage room.
Qui sul ponte più alto, alle mie
Here on the upper bridge, behind me, there's the swimming pool with glass walls and steel handrails.
L'arredamento di questo
The furniture on this bridge can all be modified to how you want it. You can move the pieces, the tables, the sofas. Too much like hard work? No, cranes do it all.
Questo è
This is the sun deck. Bit of sun now, please. Thank you. On the lower deck, you'll find the guests' quarters. I do hope you will get to be one of them, as you will have 520 square meters at your disposal, communal areas included, of course. You can tell it's a luxury mega yacht because there are fewer passengers than crew, 12 versus 14.
Le cabine per gli ospiti sono quattro per una capacità massima di 10.
There are four cabins for guests which have a maximum capacity of 10 people and each is as big as the main cabin on a 20-foot yacht.
Ogni elemento d'arredo è stato
Every piece of furniture has been designed and made just for this yacht, even this sofa.
Questo salotto si affaccia sul mare.
This living area faces onto the sea, opening up onto these 10-meter long terraces. Truly gorgeous.
Qui trovano posto anche due tende.
There's space for two 9-meter tenders here that are moved by this crane.
Questo gancio.
This hook alone costs 1,000 euros.
Come sulle barche a vela,
anche As on other sailboats, this one has a hatch too. It's just not one that takes you below deck, but straight to the beach club, and it's huge.
Se volete tenervi in forma, c'è
If you want to keep in shape, there's a gym too. And if you're in harbour, open the big door and just watch the spectacle of the sea. We, though, want to check out the engines, isn't that right?
È il momento di dare I numeri. È lunga 50.
Here are some figures. It's 55 meters minus 20 centimeters actually. Width is 10 meters plus 20 centimeters. And two 1.63 Caterpillar engines drive it.
Se dovessimo calcolare le prestazioni sulla base del rapporto peso-potenza, I risultati sarebbero sconfortanti.
If you need to calculate performance on the weight-to-power ratio, results would be a little disheartening, as we're talking 241 kilos per horsepower. But speed depends on other factors too, like the shape of the hull.
Ecco perché l'Atlante raggiunge I 15 nodi.
And this is why the Atlante gets up to 15 and a half knots and can hold to a cruising speed of 14.
L'andatura economica di crociera è di 12,5 nodi con un consumo di circa 20.
The most economical cruising speed is 12 and a half knots and with that it consumes 27 liters per mile and as the tank holds 120,000 liters of petrol you can go as far as 4,500 miles. Yes, that means you can cross oceans. If you wanted to go around the world you'd need to fill up 9 times. But if you fill it up over there where it costs less, you'd only spend 250,000 euros. That's to cross the world on this mega yacht.
Ah, sì.
Oh yes.
Dalla regia mi ricordano un'altra importante fornitura, quella idrica.
The director is reminding me of something else to tell you. Water. There are 30,000 litres on board, so if on average you use 30 litres per shower, you could have 1,000 showers. But there are only 26 people on board.
Ma siccome c'è anche un dissalatore da 800 litri ora, ciascuno può.
There's also an 800-litre desalinator. Everyone can have 24 showers a day, no problem.
Credo che qui non ci siano problemi.
I can't imagine there'd be a lack of champagne either.